Before seeing very interesting table about the mutation Ibn Mutasiot, let us see what I see in the internet. It's frightening, but this is what they say. Mutated COVID-19 may foretell a great risk for mankind in the future. So it looks like the situation is not simple at all. So let us see what the Torah, which is the blueprint of creation, says. So this is really unbelievable table, as you see yourself, the appearance of the worlds in such a way, far away from being coincidence. So the first thing we have is the word mutations, mutatsiot in Hebrew, yeah, mutatsiot in plural. Then, what we looking for? We're looking for the corona. Many millions of Torah, you have the word corona in blue. Corona, you can see corona every three letters. Unbelievable. From the old Torah, corona comes exactly with the word mutations, frightening. So what we should do? What the Torah tells us? So look what is coming here, like two pillars. Emunah, faith. Emunah again, faith. So if you followed my YouTube, you could see what the rabbi said, that he was Shalom others, that there is a faith which is intellectual one, like people understand there is a God, like take Einstein in his book, on his life. My life, he says, no doubt there is a God, or there is somebody who looks after the world, because every split second that the world carries on is a miracle. You need only the earth to go a little bit slower. You'll be up in heaven. If the one star will clash with another one, so it's all our miracles. So he said, must be somebody who looks after this. But unfortunately, practically, to keep the Torah, to keep the laws of the Creator, of the... No. But there is another kind of emunat, which is an emotional, practical one, that a man really believes there is a God, the Creator, believes in the Torah, and he keeps it. Gentile keeps the seven laws of Noah. Few of them have to do with abortion, sexual matter, which unfortunately Democrats allows, and frightening the situation, mutations come more and more. We see every one, South African, Israeli one, Japanese one, who knows if it will come out more. What also is frightening, that exactly in this place, when you have the corona, you have three times the word nega. Yeah, nega is opposite, it's a plague, yeah. Pandemic, leprosy, and all this comes. In fact, it's written a nega, nega, which is pandemics. Unbelievable. So, what we should do? What we should do? If you want the salvation, Shua, if you want Messiah to come, so what we should do? You keep the Torah, definitely, yeah. Especially, our rabbis tell us, for Jews, that the most important is keeping the Sabbath. This is what is written, Sheshet Yamim Tzaseh Melacha, 6 days you should work, make your labor, but on Yom HaShvi, on the seventh one, Tishabat Shabbaton, with Sabbath, Mikra Kodesh, Holy Festival, Kol melacha lo ta'asu, no work you should do. So, this is exactly the most important warning, threatening, is written, our rabbis bring all over, that Sabbath is the basis of creation. In the prophets is written, Jeremiah said, Im lo b'ritzuchu kot shamayim v'arz, God said, if not my covenant, I will not create the world. And what is briti? Briti is the Sabbath and the Torah. The world was created bereshit from the Torah, which is called Reshit, from Joshua, Chorez, and Reshit. So not keeping the Torah is the end of the world, like was a flood. So, as I said, it's unbelievable that you have exactly here coming here. But all the, what appears here, unbelievable, corona, face, you know, pandemic, all come with this year, Tav Shin Pei Aleph, which is Tav Shin Pei Aleph. It is 5/7/81, 2021. Amazing. Tav Shin Pei Aleph, as you saw it in many places. This is here, 2021. So what is interesting in this table, you have the name Esther, the Queen Esther. We know her from the Megillah, from the scroll of Esther. And Cyrus, who also was in this time, he was a Persian king, exactly in that time. So, what is the idea? So, we mentioned many times that our rabbis, many Kabbalistics, say that the redemption, salvation, in future, will be similar to this one, which was in Purim. Then Esther really brought the salvation. The Jewish people returned to the Torah, keeping the Torah. And it's written that a similar situation will be, which we see today so clearly. There is a very cruel leader. Haman is named like Haman. Want to wipe out Israel, he says it clearly. Now he's very happy because Biden will renew the agreement, so then easily they can do what they want to do. Definitely the outsiders say, no, no, we are good, we will listen, but underground they will do what they want because this is their idea, this is their belief that Israel has to be wiped out. It disturbs their Mahdi, their Messiah. So what do you think, they give it up? So this situation, so Trump was able to stop it, but sanctions so on, but Biden and his fellow people, Obama, were saying, no, we can fix everything. But they don't know that basically this is what they want, to wipe out Israel. And this is why they're in the bomb. So Esther comes here, like she saved us from Amman at that time. And Cyrus will allow Jews to go back to their land. It's really why Kabbalistically, in fact, he was called by God, Messiah of God, Meshichin, Isaiah 45. Once he allowed Jews to go back to their land, even to build the temple. So this is why Kabbalah says that Trump, don't want was the same. He recognized Jerusalem, the Golan Heights, and believe in the prophecies that Jews should come back to their land. So this was exactly like Cyrus. But, you know, there is a Satan and a disturbance. This is what happened now. So, we have to wait. But who knows if all these troubles that we are going to have now with mutations, yeah, with pandemics, you know, who knows, as I said, is a great risk for mankind in the future. We see that these mutations come more and more, you know. And this is not so. The most important for Jews is what is written here, on 6 days work may be done, but on the 7 days there shall be Sabbath of complete rest, a sacred occasion you shall do no work. It shall be Sabbath of the Lord throughout your settlement. This is for Jewish people, the Sabbath to keep. But there are 7 laws of Noah, you know, that they have to keep. And some of them are really sexual matters, which unfortunately they don't keep now, abortion, homosexuality. So what we should do is written here. What we should do, prayers, tefillah. You have to pray to God, definitely. And to keep the Torah, yeah, to keep the Torah. And only then we have salvation. Only then we have Messiah. Bring peace, quiet, tranquility, all what we are looking for to make people happy and joyful. But this is also can be done by keeping the Torah, seven laws of Noah for the Gentile, and for Jews, all the laws, specifically what is very important is the Shabbos. And here we have this year, here Tav Shin Pei Aleph, it means that this year we saw that it's very suitable for it, but only to keep, if you keep the Sabbath, the Rambam says. It's an interesting and significant table for our days.